lit this time, like a fire in a blaze, gotta burn it down. Can't be afraid to leave this out. We got this far, don't know how.
Back out in Charleston on the kayak. Today we're gonna target some sheep's head around some docks. We got fiddler crabs. Right now it's low tide. Tide should be rising around 11. So the fish should be biting right now. All right, y'all, before I go in there, I'm gonna tell y'all the setup I'm using. So, for my freeline setup, I have a 3-foot fishing rod right here. It's the Dock Demon by Zebco. Y'all can see how much backbone it has. Then I have my drag really loose, so just in case if I catch a big one and they start running, it gives them enough pressure to still keep them on, but not too much pressure to where I break my line. Man, I just got an owner size 1 mosquito hook, 20-pound braid with a 25-pound fluorocarbon leader. That's for the freeline setup or split shot. Then on the beefier setup, I have a B&M 410 rod. It's initially a crappy rod, but I use it for the sheep's head because look at it. It just fits perfectly. Then I have a 1/2-ounce bottom sweeper jig. Same concept with the line, 20-pound braid, 25-pound fluorocarbon. And all of these combos right here are really inexpensive. The rod right here, the 410, it's only $10 at Academy. Zebco Dock Demon, I'm pretty sure it's only like 20 bucks. So you don't need something expensive to be out here trying to catch these fish. And for bait, we have the fiddler crab, as you can see. Baby small little crab. Got a bucket full of those. And what I do, I basically just take one side of the leg off, put the hook on its side and come out through the head. Just like that. And you see, it's still moving, which gives action, but he doesn't have enough power to climb on the piling, forcing the fall of the bait. start grabbing these pylons right here. Is that they are very sharp. Got him out of there. Okay, buddy. He wants to run. He wants to run, buddy. It's a good one, too. Might be our first keeper. Look at there. See that? See how I go in there with the bottom swooper jig, nothing? When I bring free line in there. Deep. That is the difference. Relax. These guys are very powerful. Sir, first keeper of the day. 15 inches. Inside the dock, it's not that much current. You gonna catch them because you wanna catch them? That ain't happening. These fish are picky. Now watch, I'm gonna drop in the same location where I just dropped the bottom super G. What's the difference? If there's even one in there. Yep. What'd I say? That's a big one too. A magnet toad stud. Get out of that dock. Oh boy, he wants to go on the dock. I'm gonna go on that dock. He wants to die. Big one, y'all. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. Oh, my gosh. Look at that. Oh, man. Look at that. Oh, he wants to run. Get away from that piling. Lermo? Oh, my gosh, y'all. Look at the size of this sheep's head. Holy snap. That is a magna toad. Look at that. Look at how beautiful that what I just say, yo. I dropped the bottom sweeper in there. He didn't hit. But I dropped the no weight. He hit. Incredible. That is incredible. Holy snap. And you guys can discreet me with if I keep the fish or not. I really don't care. But I'm a keeper. I drove 2 hours over here. So, man, that's a pretty one. I can't even grip my whole hand. It's definitely over 14. Guarantee it. My gosh. This fish is a beast. Okay. Oh, he's friggin' 19 inches. He swallowed it too. Unbelievable. I don't even know where my hook is. Oh yeah, he swallowed it. Swallowed it big time. Up, y'all. Man, look at that. Let's get out of this piling right here. That's a beautiful, beautiful fish right there. Unreal. Oh my gosh. That is what saltwater fishing is all about. Man. Well, Lermu, that's number two, buddy. See him? It's a beautiful fish right there. Let's get this hook out. He'll be on his way back to wherever. Okay, y'all get him. Top of his mouth. Very hard to take out. Y'all see it? Another look, 13 and a half.
Yep.
And that's what we were looking for. Y'all see it? We are drifting. See it? It's a pretty one right there. It's another keeper. Son of a biscuits. Well, it didn't end up in a freaking pool. Break my line at the same time though. He's still pull, look, yep, he's still pull. Get out, baby.
You want me to go?
No, don't worry about me.
Huh? Don't worry about you.
Don't worry about me.
Okay.
I got him. I don't care how long he wants to. He wants to fight.
Don't worry about
it. Shit.
Still pulling. I can look, look, see that?
Gotcha. He's back from the wood, that's why. I can get him out of here. He's right in the wood.
That's a big one, yo.
I got him out.
Yep, there you go.
Come on, baby. He still wants to fight. I don't know how the hell he's going to get him out. That's the problem. I don't know how to get him out. He's still on there. Stuck at it.
still on there. I can't. Yeah, oh my god.
Beacon in that last time.
Hey, he wasn't stuck. That was him. Hey, help me, yo.
Y'all, did y'all see this?
Look at the size of the sheep's head. Look at that. I'm not even gonna take the hook out. I want y'all to witness how big this is. Look at this. Look at this, you guys. That is a giant. I'm scared he's gonna shake. That's why I put the net right here. But man, look at this. Holy snap. Holy snap. I am freaking shaking, y'all. Look at that. Y'all see that? Look where I hook him at. He wasn't going nowhere. Yeah. Nowhere.
Okay, help me. Help me, bro. And you grab it too?
Yeah,
grab it too.
Boom!
Yeah.
It pulled me up.
Are you okay?
I thought he was stuck. I really did.
In my line, you break?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you got green line.
Y'all, I kid you not. He was right here in this little gap right here. You wouldn't even think there'd be a sheep's head right here of that size. I thought he was stuck. But the whole time, I just left the line out, let it do its thing, and I pulled it one hard time. He came out. Y'all, you gotta love sheep's head fishing. All right, y'all, entering low tide right now. Which means there's gonna be no current. Which means free lining will be the best bet and the most natural way and possibly the best way to catch these big ones. As you can see. But they look like they're scared of the sheep's head jig. I mean, I would be scared too, you know, that's a freaking 1/2 ounce lead weight coming through. So we're gonna try this front pilot right here, like we've been doing. And you can see maybe some fish moved in, some fish moved out. That's all we're doing. We're just basically milking three specific docks, honestly. Alright. Let's see. Pitch it in the center. Let it drop. Probably nothing but like 3-4 foot here. Try to feel that weight. Guess nobody there. Okay, no worries. Now we're gonna try this one right here. You see, we didn't catch anything yet, but since the current slowed down, it might be one sitting right there. So we're gonna ease away. It's best to be real quiet. Not try to make so much noise. Get in position. See, and this is why I use like 3-foot rods. Because gives me the leverage, and I could literally put my bait anywhere. All right, see, so there's no current right here. I'm just gonna let this thing go all the way to the bottom. Oh, I think somebody got it. Somebody got it. Somebody got it. Somebody got it. That's why. Somebody got it. Big. But it just showed that I was right with these fish. Okay, buddy. See, this guy right here has a lot of spikes. Okay. All right, y'all see him? He ain't a keeper, but he is a sheep. And we're very thankful to catch him. And we will release this undersizer. This hook out. I tell y'all, when you hook these suckers, it'd be so hard to take out because there's nothing but teeth and hard jaw bone right there. Y'all can see he's freaking flicking his tail. But y'all see it. I'm gonna get him back into the water. So when I said that somebody got it, I was literally looking at the line, seeing how slow the line went, and then my line just went whoop, instantly down. I said, "Oops, somebody picked it up." And what do you know? It was on there. That's how you could tell the bite during the free fall. All right, let's get back in position. In there close to the piling, and as close to the piling as we can. Let the line out. Okay. There's another one. This one's bigger. He'll be 14, but he's bigger, all right. Guess there was another one. Okay, buddy. Nope. 13, you guys. Y'all see it? Number, that's 13 inches right there. Okay. Hey, there's a bunch of 13 inches. Hey man, I caught three. 13 inch, all 13 inch. No, I didn't catch three. I caught two.
See? Cool, man.
But guess what? I'm gonna catch number three right here for you, okay? Get back to that piling. Hopefully, there's another one in there. Because that's two fish right there out of that one spot. Just waiting for the bigger one. All right, get in a position right here. Hopefully number three is in here. Flick that thing in there. There we go. All right, just watch our line. If that thing starts going fast, just know somebody has it. All right, we're on the bottom. Somebody has it.
Somebody has it. Somebody has it. That's number three. Number three on one spot. Okay. This one might be, okay, yeah, this one's bigger. This one's bigger. Yeah. Woo, man, look at the splash. Don't you just love it? Go in there, Tululu. That's three fish already in that one spot. Man. Yep, he's a keeper. He's a keeper, baby.